Urban Therapy with Sunshine 752, and this is your daily go-get-emism number 624. For June 18th, 2016. This is the day, this is Juneteenth weekend. And Juneteenth is tomorrow. And Father's Day is tomorrow. So I want to say happy Father's Day to all of the great fathers out there, and even the ones that are striving to be great. On their way to being good right now. Sorry about that. I just want to say, you know, give a shout out to all the fathers out there. The fathers out there that are struggling to bring together the separation of them and their children. Because that shit is important. I think it's suffice to say that there's nothing more importanter. That's right, importanter. It's going to be a word today. Anyway, today I want to talk to y'all about people who borrow money from you but still hang around you. You know, like normally when people borrow money from you and they owe you, they try to avoid you if they don't have the money to pay back. Especially if they really don't have any intentions of paying back. So they be ducking and hiding and running and, you know, maybe getting out of Dodge. They don't return text messages. They don't return calls. They let you go. They let you go to voicemail and then claim never to have gotten your message and all kinds of foolishness and craziness. But what we're talking about tonight is a different animal. We're talking about the people who owe you money, but they don't avoid you. Matter of fact, they right around there where you are. Hanging out, chilling. Come to your functions. We'll go to parties that you want to be at. You go to the club, they at the club. Might even buy you a drink. With the money that they owe you. You ask them when they're going to pay your money back. Well, first of all, you got to do your due diligence and ask for your money. Sometimes when we lend out money, we be doing stupid shit, like hoping that the person will just realize that they owe you money and they shouldn't be turning up without returning your money. So we don't say nothing. Nah, closed mouth don't get fed. Their mouth was open when they asked you for the money. Your mouth needs to be open when you ask for it back. But anyway, so yeah, we check them out doing their thing with your money. It's not necessarily your money, but the money that they owe you could be given back to you. Now, there are a lot of different ways to handle this situation. First of all, you can ask for your money back. And there are different ways that you can ask for the money back. Some people want all of their money back in one big lump sum. In my opinion, that's not too smart. Because a little bit beats a blank. And if it's a big amount of money, and you know that the people that you lent the money to are going to struggle to be able to pay you back all of that money, even though they were supposed to pay you the money back when they got the tax return, or once they got paid off of this case, or once their money came in, or once their inheritance, whatever the case may be, they were supposed to pay you back the money in one lump sum. So if you wait for that lump sum, and you know how it goes when people were supposed to get some money to pay you back, a lot of times it don't happen. So you got to take whatever you can get. So allow them to pay back a little bit at a time. The thing about paying back a little bit at a time is like this. Sometimes when people pay you back a little bit at a time, they'll make that first payment, and then they won't pay you the rest. And then when you bring it up to them again, they'll be like, well, I did give you back some of the money. So it's a slippery slope. The bottom line is, just like we said, a closed mouth don't get fed. So you want your money back, you got to get on people and ask for your money back. Make them lie to you. Yeah, that's what I said. Make them lie to you. Because not everybody tells the truth. Not everybody is built with integrity. And when it comes down to borrowing money, the only reason that people are going to lend you money is because you have integrity. That's why you didn't go to ABC Savings and Loan. That's why you didn't go to this bank or that bank. Because you knew you was going to have to give up your Social Security number. You knew you was going to have to show some credentials. You knew that your credit rating was going to come into the conversation, and you wasn't going to be able to speak very loud in that conversation because your credit is bad. So you got to go to the next man to get this emergency money. See, if you go to a bank, you don't get the money instantly. It don't work that way. You can go get that shit on a payday loan or a car title loan, but you don't want to do that. You don't want to do that because you know you're going to wind up paying forever. So you go to somebody else you know, you borrow their money, and hopefully you pay it back. But for the ones that don't pay back, like I said, they don't always avoid you. Some of them be right there all up under you. And the funny thing about it, the crazy part about it is that sometimes they be right up under you so they can borrow more money. Borrow more money. See, they fearless. Fearless borrowers. Need to write that down. They're fearless borrowers. So they don't have no problem with asking you for more money while they haven't paid you a dime back of your old money. Here's the other crazy thing that they do. You have people that'll borrow money from you, but they'll borrow a little bit of money from you. You gotta watch out for this because this is the 52 fake out. So let's say they'll borrow $20 to $50 from you. Now, then they'll pay you your money back that they borrowed from you. But that's to set it up for later. See, they've established credit with you. So they borrowed the money, they paid the money back. Now they've established a mental credit line with you. So now when they come back and they ask you for $100, when they come and ask you for $500, when they come and ask you for a stack, that's $1,000, a G, a K. When they come and ask you for a big sum of money, then it's like, well, you know I'm good for it. Remember last time I paid you back? And that's how we get got. They already established that line. Look, the bottom line is, man, you got to watch out when it comes to lending money. A lot of people say that you shouldn't lend more money than you're willing to lose. I agree. But love gets in the way. This thing that beats inside your chest, that heart. Sometimes that makes us make decisions that are less than well thought out. Let's try not to do that. Because, it makes us feel a bit worse when we feel like we got played and now we got to contemplate doing something dirty, which ain't really dirty, it's justified, to somebody who played us over some money, over a couple of dollars. It's a bad feeling losing somebody that you was cool with over some change, man. It is. It's a bad feeling, but it happens. People hanging around you that owe you money. So it's like, you know how like sometimes when you get down on your luck, you broke, you need money for an emergency, your refrigerator done conked out, your car done broke down, your washing machine done stopped working. And you be like, yo, it's a bunch of people out there that owe me money. I need to reach out to them. You can't reach out to them because they right there with you. And you know they ain't got it. It's L, yo. Good things happen to those who wait. Great things happen to those who grind. And anything can happen to those who go for theirs. So go hard, go for yours. And remember, when it comes to borrowing money, when it comes to lending money, I ain't even talking to no borrowers. When it comes to lending money, you have to be smart. You gotta be smart. You can't let your heart overrule your head. But sometimes people's heads and hearts go together. So they soft in the heart and they soft in the head. I know how it be. We all have those moments of weakness. And love makes us weak. And I'm not even talking about romantic love. We love our family. We love our friends. We don't want to see people doing bad. We have it and we want everybody else to have it too. So we help out those who are less fortunate, hoping that will propel them, will get them on their feet for a second. And, if we're down one time, then we're hoping that they will help us back on our feet. And sometimes we find out that that's just not the case, but that's just how it goes. Shout out to my peoples who came out to the Mind Right and Body Better Fitness program today. We had a ball. You know what I'm saying? Young boy. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'll at y'all tomorrow, man, for another Daily Go Get'emism show. Not even talking about this video. I'm talking about the radio show. 6 a.m. every single day. 6 a.m. every single day. Eastern Standard Time, baby. 347-677-1533. Get down with the... Yo. Yeah. Just not lending out money. You know what I'm saying?